Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Armin. Today I want to create a mesh in the watertight workflow for the Savonius turbine. This model is available for download, and you can find it on the internet. The turbine is not located in the origin coordinate. Therefore, I will move it to the origin. Next, we need to remove the extra edges from the object. There are only two lines that we remove them. We need two domains. The rotating domain is the first, and the stationary or fixed domain is the second. By clicking on the enclosure and selecting the body, we can create a cylinder around the turbine. The cylinder should be a little bigger than the turbine. Now we have a fluid domain that is rotating in a stationary domain. We have to specify the walls of the turbine in this way. We don't need the turbine geometry, so I will suppress it. After that, I will change the enclosure name to rotating and delete empty components. It's time to create the fixed domain. I'm going to click on the enclosure and select the rotating body. The domain should have dimensions at least 10 times the turbine's diameter. After that, I'll delete extra solids and define the inlet and outlet. To couple the two domains together, the domains need to be shared. The direction of rotation is important. Inlet must be defined by rotation direction. The geometry preparation is over. I will save and close it. I will add the fluid flow box and import the geometry. Check the double precision tick and click on Start. In the Workflow tab, I'm going to click on Import Geometry. I want to add a local size element for the walls of the turbine. 5 mm with a 1:1 growth rate is okay. Here I'm going to specify optional sizes. You have to create 3 different mesh sizes to achieve a reasonable accurate. I'm going to change the curvature normal to 12 degrees and cells per gap to 4. I think 8 mm for the minimum size is suitable. It's not a fluid structure interaction. The turbine is rigid, and I subtracted from the rotary domain. There is no wall between the two domains, so I will choose yes. Boundary conditions are automatically recognized by their names. We don't have fluid or solid inside the turbine. Therefore, I will choose dead. For the walls, I want a boundary layer mesh with 6 layers, where the first layer has a height of 0.5 mm. Polyhex core is the best type of element. I will choose the yes option to ensure that a non-conformal mesh is not generated. The mesh generation has been completed. Now we can see the number of cells and 6 layers. Sometimes the cells are not displayed. You can display cells in this way. Also, you can see elements of turbine wall. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel.